Welcome to the Sister Speak Show. You are listening to the tour on the Sister Speak Show, where we are covering all aspects of the music industry. I am your host, Sister Speak. The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Sister Spiritual Inspiration, shared through the arts. Sister Spiritual Inspiration, shared through Ayana, but you better call me Sister Speak. What's happening? How are you all today? It's 6:37 p.m. I'm recording from Dallas, Texas. It's about 79 degrees. And we're okay, for real this time. You know, I just want to thank everybody for tuning in. Welcome to my first-time listeners. Welcome back to my Sister Speak Show, faithful listeners, my family members. I really appreciate you all for downloading and supporting the Sister Speak Show. Shout out to Africa. Shout out to the United States and to every other country that is listening to the Sister Speak Show. I really appreciate you. You are amazing. I really appreciate the downloads. My numbers are going up, and that's how we like it, because anything going down is crashing, baby, and we do not want that to happen. Cheers. Do you have your water? Okay, let me explain. To my first-time listeners, the Sister Speak Show Network is rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts off the rip. You need to know that. You need to get that inside of you. Not only that, you'll need two things. You'll always have to have water with you, and you need scuba gear, self-contained underwater breathing apparatus, in order to go with us where we go on the Sister Speak Show. We do consider ourselves to be one of the dopest podcasts in podcasting. And we just thank you for adding us to your listening flavor and letting us be a part of your podcast shuffle. And now it's time to podcast and chill with the tour on the Sister Speak Show. Brothers and sisters, sisters and brothers, you already see what the episode is. I was just thinking to myself, like, here I am holding back what the episode is, like, drum roll, please. And you guys are looking at her. As I speak. So that is correct. We are going to definitely have a serious, heavy, heavy episode this evening on this segment, brothers and sisters, sisters and brothers. Tonight's episode. First of all, let me turn to the right page. Let me take my notes. And I already know what it is, but see, I'm going to say it because I want to make sure I'm saying the right thing, because sometimes you could change your whole episode title in the middle of the show. Snakes in the Studio Part 2, Two-Faced, Managers and Artists, Poison, Pillow Talk, He Said, She Said, Somebody's Dead. Yeah, we're going to get into it, brothers and sisters. And also, I just want you to know that Playlist 2, I put together for you all. It is all royalty-free. And tonight's playlist is sponsored by, well, it's not sponsored by, but I have to give the credit. Okay, so we have CFM Productions, Elysium Auto Labs, A Shama Love Music, OP Beats, and Nax. So thank you all for putting out royalty-free beats that I was able to create a playlist for. Or use as a playlist. Okay, let's just get into it, brothers and sisters. Let me drink some more water. Cheers. Okay, so tonight's episode, Snakes in the Studio Part 2. You know, we're just going to have to keep going until we can get these snakes out, right? Right. The last thing that you even want to discover is the fact that there's a snake in the studio and you just... Sometimes you know who it is and sometimes you don't. And when we cover all aspects of the music industry, we're not just talking about, oh, guess who put out a song? No, we're going into the music industry. We're talking about the ingredients, you know. You take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and there you have the facts of life. And so that's what it's about. It's about bringing the facts of life on this episode and keeping it 100. Now, the thing about me is that the Sister Speak Show, or what I am projecting for this segment, is all about how do we change the climate within the village when it comes to the music industry and our people, because it's the rough side of it, it's the dark side of it, it's the dangerous side of it that is taking our brothers out left and right, as well as our sisters. And the community is starting to be anorexic, because in a minute, there's not going to be anybody left for us to even have to cover if this cycle of violence continues to go, if this continues to go on, if this cycle of manipulation and deception go on. There are musicians who are talented, and there are those who are not talented who pose as musicians. There are managers who are truly professional and have a gift for business being organized in business and being able to help an artist manage their career. And then there are the shysty, janky, snake ass, rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts, managers who vibrate low and mean the artist or artist no good. And to get caught up with one of those is an eye-opening experience, if you get to live through the experience or after the experience has occurred, should I say. You have snakes in the studio. And not only that, it's connected to the pillow talking, the poison in the pillow. Okay? Poison in the pillow. He said, she said, someone's dead. Just like that. There's no in between. You don't need to calculate or anything. We know that that is the realest. And the entire blueprint or the setup for how someone will lose their life or lose money or end up catching a bad deal or end up having some really crazy stuff happen to them on tour, or just getting caught up with the groupies because you have no control over your penis, you know, we need to talk about that, because we wouldn't be able to talk about it if it didn't happen. But what we're trying to say is on the Sister Speak Show is that if music is your talent, in whatever form of the industry you participate in, why are you vibrating low? Why are you a snake in the studio? The last thing anybody needs is a grimy ass nigga on a squad that really is just out for blood and out to defame, out to slander. And some of you are jealous and you want the identity of the artist that you manage. Get into it, Sister Speak. Shall, doing, scuba gear. Let's do this. Splash. We in this thing. So we're talking about the spirit of deception, succubus and incubus, and greed. A double tongue and a two-headed snake. It's the snake in the studio. It's the snake on the pillow. It's the snake in the bed. It's the snake on the track. It's the snake in the crew. So in this music industry, the street aspect gets caught up into it. And so you begin to wonder, are you really rapping because you can and this is what you want to do? Or what is your real reason for being in it because of the violence that comes along with it? That's where I'm in. That's where I'm raising my hand like, hey, wait a minute. This isn't how we're supposed to be doing each other. Wait, this is not how the move is supposed to go. This is not a play. Wait a minute. Somebody's going to lose their life as a result of this. Kings, may I please just beckon you for a second to just stop and think and take yourself off of this high, off of this plateau that you're on. And I want you to consider the fact that, you know, you don't super rule, right? You are aware that you are a pawn in this, right? You are aware that the devil does seek to kill and to destroy and to steal. You are aware that this right here is all dark, and the only thing that will come from it is darkness. I don't give a dang how much money you're getting. I don't care how many streams, views, or anything like that. I don't care where you're popping or where you're still a colonel. My point is, if in your camp there is a snake, then what are you going to do about it? Or are you the snake? Are you that janky ass manager? Are you that shiesty ass rap label mate? Are you that janky ass, shiesty ass club promoter? Are you a janky ass blogger? What role do you play in the music industry? Are you keeping stuff going when it should have never started? What role do you play? I'm asking because I'd like to see everybody live. I'd like for us to not have to always attend funerals or have to listen to breaking news about a shootout here or a setup here. And there's nothing wrong with me being an elder to most of you all who might be listening to this show. And I'm thinking to the younger generation that you should heed and listen to wisdom when wisdom is beckoning you to do a 180. And I also have to tell you this, the reason why I'm encouraging you to do a 180 because most of the music that is out that is caught up in some bullshit, the music is bullshit itself. So here it is, bullshit begetting bullshit, which is why bullshit keeps happening. Most of you rap artists and most of you managers who vibrate low, you get no rest. You have nightmares on top of nightmares, and you're always looking over your shoulder. Now, you may say for the camera that you're not, but the Lord knows that you're getting no rest. And the demons sure do because they're the ones who keep on messing with you the moment you close your eyes. Some of you talk about, oh, I get no sleep. I'm always on the grind. No, you're afraid to close your eyes because of what you saw the last time you did. Let's just keep it real because if you're channeling into dark energies, into the demons, excuse me, into the devil himself, that's the only thing that you will get. You will get what the devil has for you. The devil doesn't come with righteousness. No, he's going to give you cotton candy with a blade in the middle. And you, liking cotton candy, you're gonna eat it and not even realize that you're getting ready to cut your tongue. But you love cotton candy. Now, on the last episode of, excuse me, of the Culture Climate, the topic was sex education, admissions of guilt, sex scandals on college campuses. And I referred to sex as Candy Jane. Because many of you rappers, managers, whoever, are addicted to Candy Jane. It doesn't have to be rappers. I don't want everybody to think that when I'm on the tour, this is all I talk about. Look, musicians in totality, okay? I'm speaking about musicians. Whatever category of music you sing, minus Nas X, Little Nas X, whatever you are, I don't condone. So, you know, and that gothic shit. But I'm just talking about a lot of you are addicted to Candy Jane. And Candy Jane is your pimp. Candy Jane is your assassin. Candy Jane is your setup chick. And Candy Jane is waiting for you after you perform. Sex is the bait. It will always be the bait to lure any man who vibrates low and who is weak. Okay? That is how you guys keep getting got. And what I don't understand and won't understand, I would like for us to try to understand, but that won't be possible, is why do y'all keep getting dominated by pussy? Rated R for strong content language. I understand the word is vagina, y'all, but you have to understand who I'm speaking to. I must code switch when I'm in the trenches. If you don't like it, click off, lily pad, because this ain't about you. This is about I'm in the trenches and this is scuba diving. And there are sharks, okay? I'm not gonna see a shark and say, oh, puppy wumpy. I'm gonna say, shit, shark. So, like I was saying, a lot of you all are addicted to Candy Jane. Pussy is your kryptonite. Why? Story after story, problem after problem, baby after baby, venereal disease after venereal disease, being set up, rob, all of this bullshit, bad deals, money taken, manager shiesty, all of it, like literally, what story will resonate with you all about your fellow colleagues in this industry? Which one, or are you all made up of invisible? And excuse me, are you all made up of being of invisibility? Do y'all think you're invincible? It's these wires. I really apologize. I'm asking you all, what is it that is getting you all so caught up to where you feel like you are invincible when it comes to sex? All it takes is for the devil to put a female in front of you, and it's over for you. We might as well just go ahead and start your eulogy now. Every time, because you niggas keep getting caught up by the same old pussy. What you mean, the same old pussy? Because some of y'all keep fucking on the same old pussy. Strong language and content, but I'm keeping it 1,000. You niggas keep passing the same female around over and over again, and you keep getting caught up. And this female is catching bodies, fucking the odds. And you lames keep going from set to set that you have no business being in, having sex with these women. What are you thinking? You're not. You just want to bust a nut. Keep it 1,000. That's all some of y'all care about, is busting a nut. You have nothing else going on in your whole existence. You've got to get some pussy, and you're willing to die in some pussy just to get some pussy. What is your purpose on earth again? We should be listening to your mixtape for what? This is what you wanted to do your whole life because you wanted to get your mama out the hood? How if you're dead? You are sex uneducated. You have no clue. You talk about the ops and you rap about the ops, but then you have sex with a female who lives where the ops live. And you don't think the ops haven't busted her down too? Everybody shoots up her club, but you want to come and perform at her club. And then you get shot up while trying to shoot up the club. I'm speaking to somebody today because some of you niggas is in the game just so you can get pussy. I'm going to call you out today. I'm code switching because it's the truth. I know how to use the proper terms, but this isn't a proper problem. This is an unproper problem that I will address it how it needs to be addressed. And then if I feel led to deliver the mail in a different way, I'll do so. But right now, we got brothers out here with mixtapes that keep mixing with the wrong female and they or the wrong manager, and they end up getting the wrong in the deal. The wrong manager. The wrong manager. I just gotta ask some of you brothers, even some of you sisters, why are you in the music industry again? What qualifies you to manage anybody? How are you managing anybody when your life is in shambles? Don't you think it would behoove you to get yourself together before you go out trying to book a show for somebody when you need to figure out your whole existence and why you vibrate low? You a snake. And you over here preying on brothers, telling them how you could take them to the next level. And only thing you could do is book one or two shows and one or two places. And then it's always all these broken promises. But the real reason why you're their managers is so you can have sex with the women who like them. You just trying to get pussy off of somebody else because you have no game in your lane. Some of you managers. Oh, yeah, I manage such and such. Always letting everybody know that. You're letting every female know that. And every female that vibrates low is going to sit there and they're going to follow suit. And it's going to be one big old stank pot of fugaziness and bullshit. And more than likely, somebody's going to get set up. Somebody's going to catch a raw deal. Somebody's going to get half of the payout that they were thought they were going to get. And somebody's going to end up get killed. And you keep all of y'all all of y'all. This is for everyone in the music industry, whether you're independent, mainstream, okay? The ones who don't have any self-control. Y'all keep having sex with the same old female. That's why all y'all niggas act alike. Because you've got so many energies inside of you that when it comes to this rap energy that you put out, it's a whole bunch of everything. That's why a lot of y'all got beef with each other, because y'all keep sleeping with each other. Inadvertently. And really. Some of y'all rap beef is because of y'all sleeping with each other. Some of y'all at the label are lovers. It's just the truth. Some of the rap beef is because that you all have slept with each other. We don't all know the details, but these are the details that do come out. And once again, y'all don't have any business sleeping with each other. Y'all don't have any business beefing with each other. But here it is, where y'all have some of you all that even beef with each other literally are talented, and you're wasting your time with on street bullshit and on pussy. All your money goes to tricking. All your money goes to making sure that you can flash it for the gram. Y'all are some of the most going livest niggas I have ever met in my life. Forget privacy. You don't want anybody in your business, but you keep going live. Turn your phones in. Turn your phones off. Keep your mouth quiet. That's too much like right. Most of you in this industry, you need a whole lot of media training, because if snitches get stitches, then I'm looking for all the stitches on you. A lot of y'all got me stitches on your tongue, because you tell on your own self. You think you moving a certain way, but you're not. You think you slicker than slick, but you not. Oh, I got it covered. I got it on lock. You really don't. You don't sit high and look low. Why do you keep on choosing to not include the most high God in the equation? Because you can't have the devil and then not believe in the most high God. And you act like he does not know who did it. That's the power in which in this whole aspect of it, that you all will never have. You can't silence God. You can't kill him. You can't stop him from doing what he wants to do. He is the CEO of all principalities. He's the head. And you all thank God for this and for that. But I know that you're not thanking the Most High. You're thanking the devil. That's your God. Yeah. That's who you bow down to. That's who makes you tick and talk. That's who makes you lean with it and rock with it. That's the one who makes you put out this low vibrating, shoot 'em, bang, bang music. That's what makes you make these artists sign these old fucked up contracts. And that's why you artists keep signing these old fucked up contracts. The devil knows what your weakness is, and that's how he comes. He's never going to come in something that doesn't move and shake you. He knows what you like. Candy Jane. You're in love with Candy Jane. She's your main thing. Yeah. Mr. Managers. Mr. Rappers. Snakes in the studio. Does that apply to you? Or are you solid? Is everybody around you solid? Yeah, we go frenemies. Who is the snake? Or is everybody a snake? Now that's some cold shit. Because let me tell you something. If anybody in your crew will go and have sex with a female who lives where the ops are from, they'll turn on you too. It's what they do when they're not around you. It's what they say when they're not around you. And in this day and age, with the advancement of technology, audio and visual, high definition and low vibrating people attached to these devices, we are living and witnessing a pandemic. No, excuse me, an epidemic. It is a pandemic too. An epidemic of setups, slaughters, and snakes in the music industry. And the one thing that no one can ever help is that Freudian slip. And you all record your Freudian slips, whether it be audio or visual. The last thing that needs to happen is that the entire gift of music be perverted with violence, manipulation, deception, extortion, murder, reckless sex, babies all over the world. Poison in the pillow. He said, she said, now somebody's dead. We'll be right back after these commercial breaks. I thank you for being a wonderful listening audience to The Tour, where we're covering all aspects of the music industry. Let's get it. Let's go. There won't be any more warnings. That's why your heart is beating fast. He's out there again. You can see him from the stage. He's obsessed with you. That's why he's taking your pictures. You're his fantasy. The latest episode of The Suspense Files on The Sister Speak Show is available on demand now, rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts on this episode, Fantasies and Felonies, Strip Club Killers. On The Suspense Files, we cover the who, what, when, where, why in urban crime, including crimes of passion, deadly relationships, mysteries, urban cold cases, and more. Click the link for the latest episode of The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Be careful. Try not to fall in love with a stripper. Sex education, admissions of guilt, sex scandals on college campuses. The latest episode of The Culture Climate on The Sister Speak Show is available on demand now, rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts. On The Culture Climate, we're covering what others are afraid to cover in the village, including controversial conversation, taboo subject matters, addressing the enemies, exposing the enemies, interviews, audio from video clips, international, national, local news clips affecting the village. Click the link in the bio for the latest episode on The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. This is your regular routine. What's different than any other day? You're not even thinking about the fact that there's pain behind the pleasure that you're seeking. The latest episode of Coming to the Stage on The Sister Speak Show is available on demand now, rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts. On this episode, pornography, behind the scenes, the price of pleasure, contracting STDs, and quitting the industry. On Coming to the Stage, we're covering theater, TV, and film. Click the link in the bio for the latest episode on The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. There's a price to pay. Can you afford it? Welcome back. You are listening to The Tour, Excuse me, on the Sister Speak Show, I'm your host, Sister Speak, the tour where we're covering all aspects of the music industry. Look, ruffling feathers, no problem. If you have a problem with anything that I'm saying, exit, okay, now, because I'm going to continue to have this conversation because it needs to be had. And it's not, this isn't the only platform where this conversation is being held, but I'm going to hold it here because I care about my people. And I care about my people coming out of a low vibrating energy. I care about my brothers and sisters, whether no matter what their age is, being able to be the royal priesthood in totality and being able to shake off the devil, because the devil is a thug. There is no man on this earth. There's no gangster. There's no rap crew, label. I don't care what set you're from. No one can out gangster the devil. And then, are you ready for this? The gangster cannot out gangster God. Now, you need to understand where you actually fall on this, if you will, just for an example, this totem pole. You're at the bottom. The bottom. So where you flex as if you are more than what you are, you're not. And so when you are at the bottom, and this isn't in a disrespectful way, this is just more so you can understand what a chain of command really is. So you can stop flexing for the gram. So you can stop all this murdering and all this, you know, horrible rap shit that y'all keep putting out. And so we can stop seeing breaking news. Maybe, you could just understand that we want to, when we're driving through the village, we don't want to see candles on the corner. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with not wanting to see candles on every corner in this entire world. In the hood, wherever the violence occurs. In broad daylight or in broad darkness, wherever. We have a right to say, damn, how many more plots have to be dug in these cemeteries? In a minute, there's going to be so many bodies that the only way you're going to have to cremate. That's the only thing. Like, why are we making the mortuaries rich? So rich. Yeah, the mortuary serves a purpose, of course. Useless point. Yes, we do fall asleep. Yes, I'm aware. But the alarming rate that your cousin, uncle, brother, husband, fiance, baby daddy is going into the morgue and then into the mortuary is alarming. And there needs to be an alert. You know, last night in Texas, the blue alert went off, which means when there has been a cop who has been shot by a civilian and a citizen, whatever, and the alert goes off because there has been a shot there. Because blue lives matter. Okay. And I'm just speaking what this organization, this principality says. Blue lives matter, okay? And we don't condone any violence at all. We do condone self-defense. However, the alert went off. And I was thinking to myself, before the George Floyd incident, everybody was, you know, this whole propaganda that was created by a white man. Black Lives Matter. Okay. And I know that many of you brothers who are in this game, the music industry, were talking about how you were appalled by what you saw with the police brutality. And some of you brothers get hemmed up by the police. Often, the police know you by name, government, and you are on the hip-hop police watch list. Most of you, Most of you are under watch by the feds right now, whether you know it or not. And you see this whole epidemic of police brutality and everything, and you get outraged, right? So, but then you go and then you kill your own, our own, one of ours. And number one, there's never going to be any type of alert that goes off when a life is lost. Only thing that goes off is a spot shooter. But my question is, how hypocritical do you not find it to be hypocritical of you to be outraged at police brutality, but then condone, consent, and perpetuate, and exact, and execute, and express in your music and in your daily life, black on, excuse me, brown on brown crime? You're a hypocrite. You need to shut the fuck up. And you need to quit. If you're gonna be outraged in totality. Look at yourself in the mirror and call yourself the ops. Call yourself the police. What you're no different. You can't call a snake ass nigga a snake ass nigga if you ain't one. Now, yeah, well, let me say this. Most snakes recognize snakes. The problem is the ones who don't. The ones who come through the crack and they just really a good guy. But they link up with a fucked up manager or a fucked up label, and then they are in the fight of their life. That's what we're talking about. We're talking about those snakes. That's what part two is about tonight. The two-faced manager, the two-faced artist, the two-faced groupie, the two-faced girlfriend, the two-faced baby mama, the two-faced record label, the two-faced industry, the two-faced devil. Real shit. Poison in the pillow. You babble, babble, dabble, dabble, drool, drool. I'd like to. Is this woman a priest? What has you confessing on this pillow? You ain't got no blood in your brain, bruh. You barely had your brain. Your brain is already barely functioning because not all, but some of you are under some serious drugs, and you're already operating on a mildly retarded level as it is. So it no wonder you got lured in the first place. You already weak. So what's just a little bit more kryptonite? Is that why you on the pillow confessing so much? Talking in love, in lust. You gonna learn. You gonna in lust transforms into in learn. But some of you will never get to the end learn because you're gonna get your soul taken out of here by violence. Damn, Candy Jane, you a cold bitch. And I don't use that word unless I am addressing a nasty ass, stank ass, hellcat, demon ass female. And you stank ass demon ass females, you bust it open for everybody. The Gap of Mexico, a straight Jezebel whore spirit in you, and you in the middle of a lot of the shit that goes on in the music industry. Number one, you won't keep your legs closed. You do need to put some Gorilla Glue in between your thighs and put that hot pocket up, but you won't because you suffer from the lowest form of low self-esteem. It doesn't get any lower than yours. I don't care where you bought your lace front from. I don't care where you buy your bundles from, your lashes, your nails. I don't care how many rappers are paying for your lifestyle. You're a bot, bitch. Rated R for strong content. You're bot. Strong content, language, and thoughts. That's the type of thing you are. You don't give a damn. Setting niggas up left and right. Using your vagina. In your mouth, in your tongue, to lure these niggas in, luring them in. You only mess with rappers. You don't care who it is. As long as he got at least one verse, you'll give him some pussy. Uh-huh. One verse. Bopping for beats. Thoughtin' for tunes. I want to be a rapper too. You are one. Trust and believe. You are. Because you like to spit on the mic. I'm not going to take my foot off your necks because you set niggas up. Excuse me. You set people up. You set men up. Well, let's just say this. You're the setup chick. You don't give a fuck. And a lot of you got a lot of bodies. There's not a trip in the world that's going to help you escape from what's coming your way. Concert after concert, tour bus after tour bus, minivan after minivan. There you are, busting it wide open with the ops. And you just got through sleeping with the ops, and then the other ops, and then the other ops. You know what usually happens to females like you? The eulogy. Some of y'all females be riding around and be in relationships with niggas that are really with the shit. And you're going to end up being a part of the bullshit, whether you want to or not, because you don't know how to walk away from stranger danger. You like to be in the thick of it. You like drama. You like chaos. You like bullshit. And you like to be right there on the edge of destruction, tongue kissing it. You love tongue kissing destruction. That's you. You like to have a menage a trois with destruction and chaos. That's who you sleep with. Mm-hmm. And that's what you are. Ravens fly out of your vagina. Every vagina, every time you bust it open. The stories that they have about you. Now you're caught up in what? Now they might be accusing you of what? You trying to clear your name now because of what? Mm-mm. You gonna get that work because it's destined for you to do so. Because what does go around, it comes around in this industry when you play around with danger. I don't care how big your ass is, but I don't care who did your BBL. I don't care what this rapper paid for or that rapper paid for at the beginning of the day. What the fuck did you pay for? Your life. You had to pay. You're going to have to pay for it with your life. The moment you decide to become a part of a setup, or the moment you decide to spread pillow talk with your own twist on it and then run back and say something, tick tock. Let me explain something to you females. I'm going to expose you. You so fucking desperate to have a rapper be a part of your count and to have a rapper give you attention. You are so desperate for love and for attention that you'll even climb through the garbage to get it. You'll even flush down a toilet to get it. You don't give a fuck where you get it from. I mean that shit. One thing is for certain, and two things are for sure. You can try to fool the world about who you are, but you will never be able to fool the Most High God. On tonight's episode of Snakes, in the studio, part two, two-face managers, two-face artists, poison in the pillow. He said, she said, now someone's dead. You make that shit make sense and it won't. Okay, tonight's clips, brothers and sisters, are for educational purposes only, fair use, to promote wisdom and to raise awareness of why violence is not okay. Why studying to show yourself approved will help you not get caught up in a bad deal or walking into a bad label. And hopefully it will help some of the labels who are vibrating low and all of the players in it. And even just, I'll just say in this music industry, maybe you'll change your ways. Who knows? But I do know one thing. You are the hoe and the devil is the pimp. Brought to you by YouTube. These clips include TMZ, The Sun, The Fumble, Thirsty. Oh, let me see. Oh, now look, let me explain this to you. There is a clip on here where you're going to hear a concert with the Migos. And it's just basically there was a groupie trying to give them head while they were performing. Yeah. Yeah, it's real in this field. Okay, brothers and sisters, check this out. Rated R for strong content language. You know what it is when it comes to the Sister Speak Show. Depending on the segment, it is what it is. Depending on the topic, it is what it is. My point is, I went to school for speech communications and I have a BA in that, which qualifies me to be able to code switch. You have to be able to speak the language for whatever the environment is. And this environment right here is gutter. It's grimy. It's real deal Holyfield. This is real stuff happening right now in your city. Wherever there's a city, there is a local rapper. And wherever there's a local rapper, there's a local manager possibly. And a local label. And there are street wars through the music and through the pussy. And you can get mad about it if you want to, but I don't care. Because I am not the one who started this. I am the one who is raising awareness along with other people saying, brother, brother, brother. Come on. Sister, 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 what's going on? You have to understand that if I want my brothers and sisters to live and to come out of the devil and do a 180, then there's nothing you can do about it. Now let's get it, let's go. The Tour, part two, Snakes in the Studio.
We are talking about the pitfalls that artists make when signing a manager contract. I'm going to talk about what should be in the manager contract to protect you and the things to look out for, okay? We're going to go over all of those, and this is going to help you become a smarter rapper. That's why it's called SmartRapper.com. I'm Rob Level. This is SmartRapper.com, and we're going to get into that right after the intro.
It's like action. Look, man, you can't get past me. You might just slap me, but you cannot last me. People talk trash me. They try and classy, nasty. They try to attack me. Then they try to attach me to the print. Number one, and the thing that my lawyers consistently make sure that every time, like, hey, make sure this is in there. And number one, and this is vital, and we're going to talk about why, it's a termination clause. It says when and how the contract can end, because if there's no termination clause, there's no time for a judge or anybody to be able to tell when the contract was supposed to end. It could be forever. That's then you don't want to get stuck in one of those. So you need to have a termination clause, because if you fall out with your manager, you need to make sure that there's terms inside of the termination clause that state that you're no longer binded by contract. Because imagine you are no longer with this
person, but they have a contract with you with no termination clause, right? And then you blow up 3 years later, and they're like, well, I saw this contract with them. That's scary. That's very scary to think about, right? So make sure that you have a termination clause, first and foremost, inside of your agreement with whoever you are signing with, okay? Number two, a cool thing that you can do is you can, inside of a clause in the contract, you can put almost anything inside of a contract clause.
Wow.
But what you could do is you can do a trial period. So you can give somebody, like, X amount of time to, like, really see results. And then after that amount of time, say, 3 months, if they're doing great, then it goes into a full-blown contract or negotiations change at certain time periods, okay? So that's always a good idea to consider, but to be honest with you, most professional, real, big level people are not going to do that with you, because I've tried to do that, I try to add it in there, but they're like, no, because they know that they're going to put in a gang of work in the startup stages and use all of their networks, and they're like, well, what are you just going to use me for 3 months, and then what if somebody better comes along with a smaller manager, somebody who's not high level, like maybe somebody you know is your cousin's uncle or somebody that really wants to manage you can start with a trial period, and that's a fantastic idea because you get to see what they're going to do for you, and again, make sure you have that termination clause in there, all right? Number three is you're going to want to make sure that there is an end date to it, and this is part of the termination clause, but you want to look at the length of the contract, and let's talk about that for a minute. The length of the contract is very important because you want to make sure that you're not stuck with this person for 5 years. Sometimes, and I've heard of this, managers try to get somebody into a contract for 5 years. The best bet is you try to get it around 6 months to a year, and most managers will do a year, but most real big managers are like, no, we need to do 2 years here. Now, the reason it's hard to talk a big dog person down from 1 year because they're like, well, I need 2 years to develop this and make sure this goes through. So 2 years is okay. And like I had a 2-year contract and that contract, but inside of it also had a termination clause so that we could terminate it at any time. And after a year, it was just over a year. It just wasn't working. So, you know, we terminated it and we're still friends. And I just texted him the other day and we have lunch next month. Like, so it's like a, you know, you still end on good terms, but sometimes the manager doesn't fit with the right person or where you're at in your career doesn't make sense for what links and connections that they have. And again, that's another conversation, but that was number three. Number four, oftentimes when it's a big dog manager or anybody who's smart and knows contracts, what they have is inside of the contract, it'll state that they're going to consistently make money from you year after year. This is a normal thing, and typically the number will go down year after year. But says, look, because I managed them and I gave them all these opportunities, I still want to get paid from this person for years after. And I had a contract with the guy who used to manage the Hollywood Undead. He was like one of my series first managers. And in the contract, he said he was going to get 10% the year after our contract was terminated, and then 5% and then 2%. So it was like 3 years after he was still going to make money, had that continued to go through. And this is in there. This is for them, obviously. And it makes sense. If they provide you with all these opportunities, then and they give you all their connections, they want to get paid from all the work that they put in even after the contract is terminated. You want to try to avoid having this happen and not have this in contracts, but sometimes with a big dog person, like, they know the power of it and they don't want to remove that. But try to make sure that that is not inside of the contract, because it's going to cost you more money. Suddenly you're going to have a new manager getting 20% and then your old manager getting 10%. Now you're giving out 30% of your money. Keep that in mind. Let's move on. This is a fantastic one, especially if you're a business person like myself. You need to make sure that in the contract it says that they're not going to get any money. You need to exclude any other businesses that you have, because typically it says they're going to make 20% of anything that you have or that you're making money from. If you're somebody like me who owns a bunch of LLCs, like if I sign a contract with a manager, I'm not going to give him, like SmartRapper.com is making like $80,000 a year plus. I'm not going to give him 20% of SmartRapper. You have nothing to do with SmartRapper, so you need to make sure that whatever your contract or your business is, if you have a side business or you have an income from another place, you need to make sure that it states this in the contract that they're not going to get 20% of that, because typically a manager gets 20% of everything.
Oh, God.
Okay, you need to be careful of that. That's a huge one. Especially if you're really making money. Always review the contract. Have another lawyer look at the contract and re-review it to make sure that everything, it looks right. You know what I'm saying? Make sure that you have a real lawyer review this. Don't review it yourself. Don't give it to your buddy to review it. States are different. Every state has different laws and different things where things come into play. And only a lawyer from that state knows the laws, right? So get the right lawyer. Pay him a little bit of money. It's worth it to not get screwed. And then get that contract signed. All right? On top of that, make sure that you double check the percentage. Make sure you are looking at these numbers. Not only have the lawyer look at it, make sure you read it and try to understand it to your best ability. Because all that a contract really is, and the reason lawyers make so much money is because they understand how to decipher ways that people say things that screw people. And that's what contracts are. They're always trying to screw you. They'll say it with one word that you may not understand and a certain sentence structure that you don't understand that links in another clause in the contract that writes out that or amplifies a different clause, and you don't see stuff like that. That's why a lawyer is important, because you'd be like, I don't really understand this part. And that one little part is what could cost you $100,000. Number seven, on top of that, this is the thing, right, is that going off of what I just said a minute ago,
what?
The length of a contract between you and a manager should be anywhere from 1 page to 3 pages. There's no reason it's like super stupid long. That is, 2 pages probably is like a strong amount, and if it's a new manager, 1 page is enough. When I signed these big dog contracts, they were like 2 pages long. So think about that. These are real big dogs, and it was only 2 pages. It doesn't need to be a crazy length, and if it is a crazy length, I would be a little bit scared, okay? And I would consolidate that down and make sure that a lot of the extra garbage and gibberish that I'm talking about is cut out. And lastly, number eight, make sure that you have a signed copy of the contract so that you have an exact example of it, because you don't want them going to court with something like, I didn't sign that, but like, how do you know? Because you don't have the original contract, right? And make sure that you have a signed copy, and that you not only have a signed copy of it, that you then have copies of the copies, and you place them in places that are safe, so you have them as backup. All right, I'm Rob Level. This is SmartRapper.com. Hit that subscribe button, and when you do hit the subscribe button, please hit that little bell, because it's going to notify you every time I release a video so you can become a smarter rapper. This is SmartRapper.com for a reason. I'll see you guys tomorrow, because I release a new video every day. Here's some more videos.
Jason, what's up, big dog?
Tell you what's up. Big dog Jason Derulo leaving Argyle, and big dog's got an appetite. Check out this party bus. Two chicks waiting. 3, 4, 5, and... not 6.
Everybody gets in except for one lady, and she is pissed.
You guys want to know why I'm not going? Okay, I'm telling you right now why I'm not going.
Oh, we are all ears.
You want to talk it? Let's talk it.
Let's talk.
He makes me come here.
Derulo made you come here?
Yes. I'm from Brazil.
Would have guessed Finland. Well, I guess she claims Jason specifically invited her, but then she got the door slammed. Which would mean...
something happened in club.
But what, Aries?
This woman is insufferable. She was in the club, and they're listening, and they're thinking, how do we all get out of here? Jason Derulo said, you can all come with me. She can't come.
But isn't there a code, like, no chick left behind?
No.
Yes. My friend is inside. She's texting me.
What'd she say?
It's so she's that we get an Uber.
I would've just jumped on the bus.
I'm not gonna jump in the bus if he don't go with me. I'm not gonna be like one of the girls.
Okay, maybe that crazy laugh is the reason you're not on the bus. Anyway, you don't want to hook up with Jason Derulo. A celebrity like him could never truly love you, but perhaps true love is standing right in front of you.
We look great today. I don't know why they even jump on the top.
What do you want?
It was an inside job because of how calculated the whole thing was. Those killers know he was going to be there. You know, there's somebody in the inside that knew where he was going to be at the exact time and when he was leaving that exact time for them to know when to come and to do what they did. At that time in his life, he was trying to change. I don't remember him being in any type of a controversy with anyone at that time. So it was for financial gain. I don't know what other reason it could have possibly been for, you know. What could have been more important than someone's life? It's even gone as far as that. I can no longer visit my brother's cemetery. I can no longer visit his gravesite due to them trying to do anything to break me down, to keep me, you know, fearful of them. I don't know what their tactic is or what the reason behind it for, but it's just, it's not right. It's evil. It's what did I do, you know, to you? My brother's gone. He's gone. Like, what more can I do, you know, than just to visit his gravesite and just to sit there and talk to him? Like, I get closer to him once I'm there. To his fans, I want you guys to remember the positive things that my brother has left behind for you guys. Remember him as a person as well. You know, he wasn't perfect, but he was still, you know, such a beautiful, beautiful person. So remember him as, you know, a young man who was trying to change and didn't get a chance to do so.
I'm sorry to know you. I'm sorry to know you.
A Clippers player flew an Instagram model out to LA, then she blasts him. Hey there, welcome to The Fumble here in Los Angeles. I'm Crystal Rich. Thank you for watching. Make sure you join our notification squad by pressing the red subscribe button below to stay up to date on the latest sports news. Dating is very weird this day and age. If you're into online dating, you usually meet the girl or guy virtually first, then ask them out opposed to the old school way. Well, Clippers power forward Montrezl Harrell learned the hard way. Harrell was reportedly talking to a female on Instagram and wanted to see her in person. She posts a lot of mirror selfies in the bedroom, half-dressed, so you can only imagine why Harrell wanted to fly her out. But little did he know, she would document the entire trip. A few folks on Twitter said it best. This girl I follow on Instagram was so happy an NBA player was flying her out to LA that she posted the whole conversation with this dude's name in it and everything. Be careful of women like that. She was faux show on the flight the next day, though. Here is what she posted online. The first of many pictures is her bags. She wrote, "Pack for LA," but at least she knows how to pack lightly. The next was her flight itinerary. Now, we know that she was flying out of Phoenix. She wrote on the picture, "LA tonight." At least she was smart enough to block out her name and flight number. As we start to get warmer on what her night might entail, she puts out another screenshot. It looks like she was tracking the Clippers game against the Timberwolves. She said, "Look how close the score is." All of these clues are starting to add up, but if we're being honest, what she posted so far wasn't that bad. Any sports fan going to LA might post the same thing, but here is the kicker. The Instagram model posted this picture of Harrell's car with the caption, "He got a nice ass crib, go me." Wow. This girl tweeted a picture of his car and part of his house. Obviously, Harrell was not happy about it. The second-year player who is still trying to make a name for himself in the league tweeted, "It's the reason I say solo, solo." Well, at least now we know why you're single. Your taste in women is just a little bit questionable, and now everyone has your license plate number. What would you do if a girl or guy did this to you? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching The Fumble. I'm Crystal Rich.
So let me explain this clip. Normally I don't speak over these clips, but I have to let you know what's going on. This is the Migos at a concert, and a groupie in the audience is trying to give them fellatio while they perform on stage. So that's what this is about.
By the time we get off stage, Who's on?
That's Chris Brown in the background.
I'm about to go pick up my nigga. You feel me? Like, this is just how it works.
I really think this is just a spoof. I really don't think this is what's really, really happening. I think they're playing around.
Yo, so I just don't understand.
Word, that's what I'm talking about.
The show, I was turned after the show. I was playing ball, it was live, everybody outside turning up. So it's time to go, you know. I started getting something, go back to the room. We went back to the room, made it happen. Now it's her turn to take care of bro. You feel me? She don't want to take care of bro, so it's time for her to go. You get what I'm saying? All right, man, you live. Big commotion, police, oh, he, all that never happened again. So that's one of my wow tour stories. It's just lead her. Drunk groupies alone. At least go for the sober groupies. The drunk ones, leave them alone. Here's a wild tour story on the Kevin Gates tour. I don't get tired of tour, man. All right, so, well, I'm new. You know, I don't really know too many people. If they do know me, it's fun. It's rare, you know. So we're actually out there, man, and some guys, there's a group of guys, like, we couldn't tell if they was either hating on us, you know, or they were trying to be cool because they was walking behind us, man. So we get to this mall. This is huge mall that was out there, man. So it's a store called Foot Locker. I had on all red. all red and started and talking some smooth blood. My cousin told me, like, man, they talking to you. I'm like, oh, man, I ain't no blood. We family, everybody family. So that was just another one right there, man. We almost got two with the wrong gang over nothing, wrong colors. So that's another one right there.
About somebody posing as a groupie. But really, they're up to something more devious than that. A fake groupie, I guess you could say. Maybe to set somebody up, to rob, to extort.
Nah, me, I don't worry about that shit because I don't even be giving these groupies no time.
There was a time, though, when you did give groupies time.
Yeah, yeah.
Why'd you stop?
Shit, get old.
And I know in that groupie story that when all your buddies ran on this one person, you didn't. Mm-hmm. Okay? Why didn't you that night?
That's when that shit got old, shit. I was done doing that shit.
Ever been burned by a groupie before?
No.
Well, welcome back to the tour where we're covering all aspects of the music industry. I am your host, Sister Speak, and you're listening to the Sister Speak Show. Well, that was a nice mixture. Started off with what you really needed to hear. You need to know what a contract consists of and how to read it. Because if your manager never presents a contract to you and does not have their paperwork together, you need to question who is your management. Some of you don't need a manager. Some of you do. It just depends on how you're moving. The thing about it is, the snake aspect of this episode is this. Some of you managers, real talk, as I mentioned before, you're getting pussy and clout off of your artists. And when you're not around your artist, you use your artist's name to get sex, to get females. And some of you have taken on the spirit of jealousy and you really want to be the artist. You really want to rap or sing, but that isn't what was given to you. And you really want that spotlight. So the closest thing to the spotlight you could find is posing like a fake ass manager and representing the artist. And then some of you managers be caught up in too much street shit. And now your artist is a part of it because you moving real dirty in these streets. And the artist has no clue that they're signing up for their death because you're full of shit and you are a demon. Some of you go right behind the artist and sleep with whoever they're sleeping with. Some of you be laying on the floor in the hotel room hoping some pussy crumbs fall off the bed. Got him. You be staying there. You lay on the floor with your mouth open hoping for a drip or a drop. All of you know what role you play in this industry as to how you end up backstage hoping that you get chosen. Some of you have a whole, you know, thing that you do where if one comes back, everybody's getting pleased. That right there is some bullshit. And you sisters who actually go back there and you just one after the other just keep getting, you know, violated and allowing yourself to be violated. Woo. Y'all haven't heard me say it once, but I am going to say it now. Childhood trauma affecting everybody involved. So you janky managers that are doing your artists dirty with these old fugazi contracts, and then with your street beef, and then you behind your artist's back cutting shiesty deals, getting caught up with the ops, running your mouth. Your whole thing is just not smooth. You have no business being a manager is what I'm telling you. And you need to quit today. Stop coming in this music industry representing yourself as a manager when you know good and damn well that you are a snake. You don't know the first fucking thing about managing an artist. How do I know? Look at your life. You're always in some shit. You're always caught up in something. Nobody can trust you. You have a bad rep wherever you go. Your name stinks. Your energy is funky. And you're a setup nigga too. Poison in the pillow. He said. She said. Now somebody's dead. And the blood is on your hands too. Oh yeah, I'm pushing a major artist into the grave. Oh yeah, I'm pushing a major artist out the way so you can have sex with all of the chicks that he's taking down. Now you want to be a rapper too. Now we got to go listen to your album too. Why? We don't want to hear shit you got to say on wax. Why? So, you're in this industry again for what? You've got three artists for what? And most of you managers, you go out there, not today. You go out and you look for female artists, no matter what type of category of music they're in, and you only reason why you're after her is just so you can have sex, and you are looking for a girlfriend, have no game, and so you're using this music industry as a disguise just so you can get next to a female because you're a lame. And then you go out here and you do these women dirty in the industry. You have no type of deals on the table for them. You're always fucking up everything. You have no budget for them. And they're always having to fund their whole thing. Why are you their manager again? Oh, because you just want to hit that. Some of you want to manage these artists so you can sleep with these men. Some of you are on the down low. You like men on the under. You're a womanizer on the over. On top. And you really just want to have sex with your artists. Some of the beef is because your artists had to beat the brakes off of you because you tried to try them. Whether they be male or female. Some of you are snakes. And some of you artists are trying to escape from your manager. And your manager doesn't want to let you go. Are you that type of manager? Because you know if this artist leaves, that your entire credibility, the lack thereof or thereof, will be diminished even more or more. Some of you will kill your artists if they tell you that they want to leave. Some of you will set your artists up if they want to leave. Some of you make it hard for them to leave. And that goes back to that contract. Did you read the contract, artist? Or were you just so happy to get on? Because all you could think about was all the candy rain you were going to get. Candy rain. You're in love with her. That's why you signed. You didn't give a fuck about what none of that contract said. You get a lawyer for what? You good? You trust this nigga? You grew up with him. What could go wrong? Well, here we are at your funeral. That's what went wrong. Your album dropped the same day your casket did. It's heavy. It's heavy in the streets, man. Candy Rain lures you straight to the grave. And Candy Rain is kryptonite for everybody involved, even the females. You know, going live, showing the entire world that you're at a celebrity's house, we literally don't give a fuck. And you need to know that deep in your spirit the next time you get ready to go live, sis. We don't give two fucks about that. Why? Because we don't care. Because that don't make us move. We got Gorilla Glue on our swag. That don't make us move. I mean, when you are confident in yourself and you are somebody, when you run into other somebodies, only thing you can do is just give them a pound, but not a pound by giving them the hot pocket. You know, hey, shout out. You should never, excuse me, gawk or go crazy when you see a celebrity. You should be cool. I don't know why your goal is to sleep with a celebrity, but that's your goal. And you need to ask yourself, why? Why is it my goal to bust it open and be skeeted on by an NBA player, a rapper, an actor, whoever is in the entertainment industry that's trending or not? Some of you guys will take local skeet. You don't care. We've never heard of this guy. You have, and he's your favorite rapper. And you're going to do everything you can to be either his baby mama or his baby paper towel. You know, I was just thinking about those girls in the video. You gave 15 males oral sex back to back. Is that what we doing now? They don't want to be your boyfriend still. The only reason why they're going to call you is just for that. What was the point of that? What did you have to prove? And it's, you know, groupies come in all races. But I've noticed that the ones who do not come from the village, you love our men. Why? You take some serious skeet shots from our brothers. Why? It's real in the field. Lose your mind backstage. Ain't been to the gynecologist, but the whole crew knows what your vagina looks like. I'm just saying, though, Candy Jane. That's why you niggas give such shitty shows. Because the only thing you care about is getting fucked and sucked in the back. We paid $25 to $85, excuse me, or however much the ticket is to come to your show. It's 295,000 of you on the fucking stage. And you give these horrible ass shows, but then you go back because the only thing you're worried about is getting backstage and getting to the evil, to the smut, to the devil. You've got some more work to do for the devil. It's in your contract. Horrible shows. Yeah. We're going to be at clubs such and such. You, who's we? Because I'm not coming. Only reason why you guys are booking shows, most of them, is so you can have sex. Because that comes with the industry. It was promised to you. It's a part of the package. And the same females that come with this package are a part of another package that you weren't there for that specific meeting. The one where they have been assigned to lead you to your death, to destroy you. You weren't there for that meeting. You don't run into these women by accident. You do know that, right? They're placed. Well, now the question is, who placed them there? You don't care. All you care about is pulling out either 1 to 12 inches of your penis and putting it in the lava. Damn, why you have to say 1 inch? Because these are facts. You don't think everybody is just blinding the room when they, you know, reveal themselves? No. You know? Some have to put your chia pet spread on it. I'm just saying, keeping it 1,000 moving forward. But here you are, lame ass show, doing lame ass shit behind stage with lame ass females getting caught up in lame ass shit. And you end up on a t-shirt. Your next photo op is on a t-shirt. That's the last thing. You know, some of y'all be falling in love with Candy Rain, and Candy Rain don't give two fucks about you. And you even be wanting Candy Rain to have your baby. And it's because of the Candy Jane that you're in love with Candy Rain. But Candy Rain also wants to have sex with some other guys. You're not the only one. See, she's on a warpath. Women are not the same that they were back in the day. The masculine energy that women are embracing is scary as all get out. The girl said, I don't care if I got put out. At least I fucked. Well, damn it. That's something that most men say. I don't give a fuck. At least I fucked. They don't care. At least they fucked. That's the goal. Now, we have to ask ourselves in real time, in real talk. And now what? Whoring yourself out depletes your energy. It delays your development. It hinders your spiritual growth. It leaves you open for STDs, unwanted pregnancies, violence, and death, disc records, snaky management, snaky label mates, snaky ops. I don't know what comes over you all when you get into bed with these girls. It makes me think that a lot of you all have mommy issues. And a lot of you really need to get it off of your chest. You want to talk. But most of you get into bed and you want to talk shit about the next nigga. And then the female wants to talk shit about the next nigga. And it's all for attention. You be wondering who's the female sometimes. Because you niggas gossip like old ass white women. I don't know how that got out. Your mouth, my nigga. Are you for real today? We'll be right back after these commercial breaks. Like, for real, for real. And why you created your online dating profile. And sometimes those roles can prove deadly. The latest episode of The Suspense Files on The Suspense Speak Show is available on demand now. Rated R for strong content, language, and thought. On this episode, dying to date, online dating the profile predator. On The Suspense Files, we cover the who, what, when, where, why in urban crime, including crimes of passion, deadly relationships, mysteries, urban cold cases, and more. I know you're looking for love, but you shouldn't be looking for love in all the wrong places. Click the link for the latest episode on The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Be careful. You're in love. You never thought that your wife would put antifreeze in your drink. You never suspected that your new bride would hire a hitman to kill you. Now you're out for a morning jog and someone is following you. The latest episode of The Suspense Files on The Sister Speak Show is available on demand now. Rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts on this episode. Death Will Part Us. Murder for Money. The Black Widow Bride. On The Suspense Files, we're covering the who, what, when, where, why in urban crime, including crimes of passion, deadly relationships, mysteries, urban cold cases, and more. Before you go and propose, before you order your bride in the mail, listen to this episode of The Suspense Files on The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Welcome back. You are listening to The Tour on the Sister Speak Show, covering all aspects of the music industry. Tonight's episode, Snakes in the Studio, Part 2, Two-Faced Managers and Artists, Poison in the Pillow. He said, she said, somebody's dead. The problem with most of this is the bad bitch era. It's the need to have one. And most of you need to understand what you're asking for. You're getting what the fuck you ask for. Nothing more, nothing less. I got to have me a bad bitch, and you will have one. You will exactly have what you just said that you wanted. A bad bitch. You want a non-righteous acting female dog, and you shall have one. That's how you got set up. Because poison kills. Whenever you ingest poison, you must call poison control and head on over to, poison control always leaves a warning label on anything that is poisonous. And if you ingest it, you better get yourself to the ER immediately or you will die. And many of you are dying slowly because you will not stop drinking and eating poison and sleeping with poison and hanging out with poisonous people. A snake, for the most part, is venomous. Poisonous, and you have to treat a snake bite. The reaction does not wait. It is called anaphylactic shock, and you will die. Some of you are in a slow anaphylactic shock and have no idea that you have been bitten by a snake, only when it's too late. Some of you catch wind of it and you handle it. Some of you right now know that you've got a snake-ass manager. Some of you know that you got snakes in your crew and that the female that you're having sex with is a snake too. Cheers. Your music, your appearance, and your energy suggest that you have demons in you. So I'm not surprised by any activity that occurs. What I would like to ask you is, when is it going to stop? When are you going to stop being hoes for the enemy? When are you going to stop gossiping? When are you females and males going to stop saying shit that nobody said? When y'all gonna stop adding more to the story than what was? And then when are you gonna stop getting involved in shit that don't have anything to do with you? And I'm speaking to the community, the village. The village plays a part in a lot of the bullshit that goes on in the village. Some of you keep perpetuating the snake mentality and like to see it. You are allergic to righteousness. You want no parts of it. You like to see these labels funking. You like to see the downfall. You live for the shit. And so you carry the gossip in the village and you add your two cents to it And some of you say something that somebody said that they didn't say, and here comes death. And some of you shoot the wrong person, and now the mistaken identity is on your hands. Some of you brag about it through song, and then soon thereafter, the Grim Reaper comes to your label and snatches one of your people. And then y'all go and retaliate. And just the Grim Reaper is like, give me everything you've got. I am here to collect as many of y'all as I can. But you don't care because you're too busy getting sucked off. It's a different story when them bullets start flying. When you're being chased, when you're being set up, when you're in the middle of getting oral sex and then the ops bust into the room and there ain't shit you can do about it. Having babies by the ops baby mama, are you niggas dumb? You have to be. There is no other word to describe it besides dumb as shit. I'm talking about no brain cells. And that's the same thing for the female. There's poison in the pillow. And you're gonna have to get to the ER or else you're gonna die. There's poison on your album, your mixtape, everything you all talk about is poison. So, are you two-faced? Do you pillow talk? You set tripping? Sex tripping? Tell me, what role do you play in the music industry? Are you selling your soul? Did you sell your soul? You got into the music industry because this is supposed to be something that you really wanted to do. You never expected to get caught up in any type of shit, but here you are caught up. And I'm seeing that it's hard to walk away. And I'm also seeing that a lot of you all like to use the spirit of intimidation and fear to paralyze people from operating in their free will and to go around life freely. And the question is, why do you do the evil things that you do? And do you want to stop? Or are you on a complete warpath to Hades, Sheol, the Lake of Fire, Gehenna? And you are aware that you will not live. You are aware that there is a spiritual death, that you are dying as we speak. You are aware that you're a zombie. Some of you just don't give a damn about yourselves. Your self-esteem is low. That's why you do and say the shit that you do. That's why you move the way you move. That's why the things that excite you excite you. You don't vibrate high. And I don't think it's cool that anybody gets killed. I don't think it's cool that anybody goes live and the next thing they know they're being robbed or murked. I don't think that any of the spirit of hostility that is plaguing all the hoods is cool, because I see you brothers as brothers. But some of you, I have to then take that label away from you and just call you demons. You know? I'm not with gang. Excuse me. I'm not with the devil. And none of his symbols, signs, none of that shit. So, I care, but I'm not going to care more than you do if it means that I got to drain my energy trying to convince you to come out of something that you too deep in. But I do want you to know you're deep in it. The identity crisis of wanting to be who you're not is the reason why you're a snake in the studio. That's why you have to go behind your man's and do everything he does. That's why you're pillow talking. There's something wrong if you got to keep going behind and having sex with the same old female. Y'all ain't got no game. And I'm not promoting fornication. I'm just saying, like, why y'all niggas keep having sex with the same old bitch? The same old snake ass bitch that has fucked all of y'all and gives no fucks about none of y'all and will throw your life to the highest fucking bidder. Don't you ever forget that shit. Whoever the highest bidder is, that's your pimp and that's your grim reaper. And all it takes is a snake ass female who lives in a certain area or not, who is intrigued and turned on by material things and lust after power and has a whole addiction to rappers or musicians or entertainers, celebrities, athletes, and will stop at nothing to run through you. And only thing that she needs is some Louis, Prada, Gucci, some Louboutins, a trip, a condo, that's it, and a couple bands to murk you. You will be murked. And you need to know that. I don't give a fuck how fine she is. She was sent for a reason. Will you pass the test or will you be laid to rest? Some of you had to give up with all of your backstage escapades because you caught something and it's payday when you pull out your penis. No, I'm not talking about like make it rain. I'm talking about like your penis is like a payday bar. I'm talking about Braille. I'm talking about, yeah, too much. Some of you have had to deal with groupies accusing you of sexual assault. And I'm gonna be real with y'all. Some of y'all baby mamas, see, the thing about it is, y'all talk about bad bitches, but then we be seeing your baby mamas and that don't be the case. I'm keeping it a real tune. I'm keeping it 1,000 tonight. Some of y'all be having sex with gutter ass bitches and you be getting caught up in gutter ass shit. Your baby mamas ain't shit and y'all be dunking off your semen into some ain't shit ass females, but I'm starting to think maybe you ain't shit either. There's a lot of lust babies that are born. There's a lot of, you know, I'm finna get mine babies born. Like, babies not being born in a mutual relationship of understanding and caring and love. Just born just because you just want to have sex. And some of you females are having these babies just so you can say that this is said rapper's baby. Oh, this is, this MC, gang pooing them. Who? Who? You know, MC Gang Poo. Ken S. Oh, this Too Tall baby. Who? I'm sorry, who? You will have babies with rappers that nobody has ever heard about. And I'm not saying that you should be having babies by rappers that we've heard about. But I'm saying, I've seen some of your baby daddies, and it's like, the problem is some of y'all be having sex with people that, let me shut up. I'm not even going to say it. Let me bring this on back. Candy Jane, is your addiction, and it's part of the reason why you're a snake-ass manager, a snake-ass artist, and a snake-ass female that does snake-ass shit, and you taint the music industry because you have no fucking business being in it, and you bring your bullshit to an industry, and then it makes the industry look bad, and it stereotypes a lot of brown people from the village because they only think that we vibrate in that way. And I would like to think that you brothers would have more class and more dignity and more be more conservative about your body. But I see that you choose to be whoremongers and don't give a fuck about yourself. And I'd like to ask you, who taught you not to give a fuck about yourself? Who taught you to talk too much? Who taught you to act like a female? Your energies are imbalanced. That's why you pillow talk. You know, I ain't never told nobody this before. That's you, nigga. The I ain't never told nobody else before, nigga. That's you. You know, I don't want you to tell nobody. Okay, you can trust me with anything. You know, I don't know. I keep all my secrets. I'm loyal like that. What is it, baby? I got you. What? Tell me. You know, the other night, you know, we slid through and laid them niggas out. Woo, woo. Oh, for real? Well, shit, you gotta do what you gotta do. Them niggas shouldn't have been fucking with y'all. You know, it is what it is. I feel you. You know, I appreciate you for listening. But, you know, like I said, don't say shit, you know. Because, you know, I wasn't supposed to say shit. But I feel like you cool, you know. We vibing, we bonding, you know. We got close and shit, fuck. I feel like shit, we naked with each other. Why not be open and honest? Uh-huh, yeah. Oh, baby, you know what? Let me go wash up. Because, you know, I ain't one of them nasty bitches. Let me go use the bathroom and clean up real quick. I'm going to be right out. Take her phone in there and she texting the shit out of the ops. And then. And you want to know why when you walk out the, wherever you're at, why you're getting blasted. The euphoria of the vagina, brother, has got you weak. A lot of y'all be spending the night at haunted houses. You think that she cool. You spent the night in a haunted house, my dude. Do you think if you are a rapper and you're messing with a female, and let's just say, you know, she has other guys that she's talking to. If you have any type of status, the guys that she's talking to, and if they find out about you, they're going to be jealous of you, bro. You know that, right, my dude? You can't walk around the city like you own it. You niggas is not the mayor. You don't own shit. It's my city. No, it's fucking not. Stop that. I can go anywhere I want to. I can slide anywhere I want to. That's what you vloggers. Shout out to you vloggers who make it out of these interviews. But I'm going to tell you this, and I mean this shit. In this industry, being a messy vlogger, you are tainting the name of being a journalist. You are making the artists and celebrities who we want to interview not trust us and not want to give interviews. Because you're coming in one way, but you're really a snake. And I don't have time for that. Shout out to the people who do good journalism. You know, and this is a general statement that applies to all in journalism in this world. If you are a part of the mess, and if you are going into these hoods or wherever, and you are the ops, or you are an informant, or you know that you're undercover, or you know that you're there to basically keep shit going that should not ever have been flowing, I'm telling you, get the fuck up out of the industry now and stop tainting the purity of a good interview. There are people like me who are not with the shit, who have to then hope that artists, celebrities would want to give an interview that have been burned before. He said, she said, now somebody's dead. Poison in the pillow. Some of you vloggers are sleeping with the ops. I'm talking about female ops. You're too deep in it. Every time a play is made to take one of ours out in the village, the only ones who clap are the enemy. And the enemy is not the one that you took out only. The enemy is the one who haunts the 12 tribes of Israel and hates God's people. And sets in motion suggestions and influences for you to take the wrong path to destruction. For you not only to self-destruct, but to take some people with you. To make you become a suicide bomber in the village. To make you say and do things that if you were vibrating higher, you would not do. Your childhood trauma is the factor. And the fact that you worship the devil, whether you choose to or not, is a factor. But you're knee deep in bullshit and drama, some foul smelling vagina. All you care about is flashing money. And you are a target for the Grim Reaper. You have no business in the music industry, but you're here. And I'm speaking about a music industry that doesn't exist. The coldest thing ever is to be managed by somebody who wants to be you and will stop at nothing to be you, even if that means setting you up. It's the beef that you're not aware of that can fuck up the whole label. It's the stuff that you don't see that you're trying to figure out why you're catching the heat. It's the cycle. Candy Jane is the reason why you niggas keep getting killed, keep getting set up, and keep getting caught up. It's the reason why some of you are in the industry. It's the reason why some of you women can't keep your legs closed. And have completely slutted yourself out. You smell like skeet. You're crusted up. You're crusty. And that's skeet. And then you sit there. And then you keep sleeping with niggas that you know are funking with each other. You are a whore and a snare. And let me explain something to you. Yeah. The shooter. The killer. Whoever. More than likely, it ends up being a male that dominates the mugshot. But you can rest assured, one thing's for certain, two things are for sure, that the Lord has watched it from beginning to end. And you never got away with it. Nobody involved gets away with it. When you are a two-faced person, your mask falls off. You will not be able to keep it on. I don't care if you get that Gorilla Glue. For real, this time it will move. Your mask will fall off. You cannot contain it. You can only fake it for so long, but that demon will ooze out of you. And that's how people start to peep shit. Something ain't right. Start to feel stuff. Get intuitions. Catching you in shit. That's how. Because your mask is slipping. Manager, artist, female. Yeah. That's how. The poison is in the pillow. It's in your pores. And when you sweat, it comes out of your pores. That's why. You can't help but be a snake. You can't help but slither. You can't help but bite. You're full of venom. Anybody that gets in your way will be bitten. Some of you right now are being watched by the FBI. You're being watched. You have no clue. Some of you right now are getting ready to leave out of a female's house only to be killed. I'm just keeping it 1,000. Some of you are right now about to go over there and sleep with a female where the ops stay. Because you're addicted to Candy Jane and Candy Rain called you over. If you all would really pull back your sexual addictions and energy, you would live longer. I wouldn't have to talk about this shit. I wouldn't have to see it. Seven times out of 10 of females involved when it comes to this type of beef between rappers and everything. All of it. It's always going to be 7 times out of 10 of female involved. The question is, are you willing to hold back your semen and stop always being sexually active? Are you willing to be celibate to save your life is the question. Your life is on the line. Are you willing to be celibate? Are you willing to ask for self-control, exercise self-control? Shit, some of you really should walk away from the industry right now because this wasn't even what you're supposed to do. You got in it for the wrong reasons and you need to get out of it for the right. Too much like game. You want to be the same. That's why you always walk around lame. And only a few people know your name. But you playing a dirty game because you're insane. Because you're addicted to who? Mary Jane. No, you're addicted to Candy Jane. It's real in the field. You know who you are. You know who you aren't. This is a general message. There are snakes in the studio. Are you one? Or are you not? Tonight's episode, Snakes in the Studio Part 2. Two-faced managers and artists. Poison in the pillow. He said, she said, now somebody's dead, and that's the fucking part I have a problem with. Stop killing each other. Stop gossiping. Stop pillow talking. Stop being a whore. Stop being a whoremonger. Stop being a snake-ass demon. Expiration dates come with the bullshit. It spoils and it has to be thrown out. You women have got to find something to do with yourself besides busting it wide open and being a hot pocket. It's time to stop. I'm serious as all get out. Females, the life that you're living is leading you to damnation. It is leading you to influences and avenues that you are not ready for. You think you've got it all together, but I'm telling you, you are putting yourself in the position to get killed. Because you playing with niggas who are about that life. And as long as you are setting niggas up, you will be killed. Because that's how the fucking game goes. You don't reap righteousness. You don't reap a good reward. You only reap death and what comes from the venom. You're a snake, they're a snake, and two snakes that bite each other will cancel each other out, which is the whole objective of the enemy in the first place. No one wins. If you find your purpose and your passion, and if you actually heal from all of the childhood trauma, you may have an opportunity to escape. But if you try to escape making noise, you won't get out. Some of you at this very moment need to walk away. I'm really serious about this. Some of y'all have grown up together. Some of you have not. But I know that you're all shades of brown people. And that you weren't put on this earth to vibrate low forever. But if you choose to do so, you will enter into a place of torment and terror that you are not ready for. And some of you can try to play it off, but you know the dark side of this industry when you're caught up in it. You know it. You've seen, you've heard, and you've witnessed. You've experienced it. And it's not for any type of sucker. Pink slip yourself from the microphone. And pink slip yourself from being a manager. Pink slip yourself from being a groupie. And get right before it's too late. And for some of you, it is too late. But for those of you who actually have an opportunity to get out, and you know that you have the opportunity, and you felt the warning, you know about it, you feel it. It's clear as day. I'm your confirmation. It's time to get out. I don't care who you feeding. I don't care who you funding. You better get out before it's too late for all parties involved. Stop the street bullshit. Stop the street beefing. Stop the street rap violence. Stop the funerals. Stop the tears. Stop the bloodshed. Thank you for listening to the tour on the Sister Speak Show, where we cover all aspects of the music industry. I'm serious about this tonight. Stop being a hoe for the enemy. Stop being a snake in the studio. Stop putting poison in the pillow. The Grim Reaper's in the room with you. There's more than just you all in the room. There's more than just you all in the studio. It's the unseen that you can't fuck with. That's why I'm telling you, you all don't super rule. And you can't handle what you put now. So quit playing with the devil. Because he's a cold motherfucker. strong language content and thought, rated R. However, he doesn't super rule. So like I said at the beginning of this episode, you don't have all power and you're not almighty. So when you thank God, who are you really thanking? Be encouraged and keep your head on the swivel. There are snakes in the studio. There's a two-faced manager and a two-faced artist. There's poison in the pillow. He said, she said, now somebody's dead. Be very careful. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. The Lord, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer, my God, my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I return to sender all negative energy, all satanic, demonic energy. I'm divinely protected. There are four mirrors around me. I reflect everything that you try to send my way. It has an adverse effect into your bosom, immediately 20-fold. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. This is Sister Speak with a word of encouragement. No matter what the enemy or enemies try to do to you, God will cause their plans to take no effect, and the pit that they dig for you, they shall fall in. If God be for you, who can be against you? Now say it with me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Be encouraged. My bad. Welcome back, you all. Not even welcome back. My listening audience is divinely protected. And so am I. This episode tonight is because I care. Stop letting it be that the light workers care more than you do.